Welcome to Atlanta, and it's the old Atlanta. We're racing the Xfinity cars here. I'm guessing because of the off season, this is a fun race that they do. Or I think I'm not entirely quite sure. I'm not exactly up to date on the. I don't exactly follow the forums all that much. I really actually need to be honest, but I just got so much going on. With everything else that I hardly find any time to actually kind of look at forums seriously, like actually seriously, without just like browsing them and not, you know, and not just having the information just, you know, go, you know, right through my brain and not retained type stuff.
Looks like you're clear on the pit exit. Okay, Corey, we've got 2 laps to get the job done. New fastest lap for Maniac, 30.8.
I was trying to think of the best way to say that. I think I'm going to give myself a black flag. Mainly because...
Got a black flag for me to come into the pits.
Mainly because I am the last place I-rated car, and so that would mean
you need to come in for this penalty in the next 3 laps.
Whenever it comes to time, so whenever it comes to time to grid up, I'll. There we go. That's a little bit better. Whenever it comes to time to grid up, I'll be the last car on the field. Hopefully, at least that's how it's certain. I'm sorry. I couldn't hear myself talk for a second or think because everything was a little loud. I'm gonna have to turn down the engine a little bit.
Speed limit. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
That's kind of weird that it didn't exactly give me I wonder because if it already gave me a black flag, it didn't give me the second one for driving too slowly or whatever it normally does. All right, hopefully that's good enough. I said I want to grid up. Oh. quickly. Yes, just like I thought. Starting in last place. Oh, me. Sorry about that. Let's get this car started. Oh shit, hold on.
P21, 90 laps.
I just realized I had my hoodie on.
In the inside column.
And yes, that would have been bad. Ooh. Okay. There we go. Also, good thing I'm in the very back. So, this is literally a last two question mark type of challenge.
We need to catch up to car number 19.
Also, I guess something that's pretty obvious, but this isn't the fixed series. I wanted to wait for the fixed series to come around, but I saw that the open one was open and about to go, and I honestly don't really care for a setup. I just kind of hop in whichever race and kind of go. Whenever it comes to Xfinity cars and truck races and stuff like that. Well, truck is a little bit different. But whenever it comes to Xfinity cars and next gen and stuff
nice
like that.
Stay out of trouble.
I like to try to hit
green,
the quick series, but or just fix series in general. But it doesn't really matter. Okay, there we go. Stupid hair. Alright, I think the engine noise and everything is much better now.
P20.
Let's just take it easy.
The leader was just done at 31.5.
I haven't even mentioned the fact that Atlanta is my home track, pretty much.
P19. Our lap time was 33.3.
And so let's just try to do as well as we can. It's a 90 lap, so it's going to be a pretty long race.
Fastest lap for Maniac, 31.3.
How many times are we getting in? Oh, only two.
Okay. Baker, it's getting closer. The gap's now 0.2.
God. He's still there.
Alright.
shit. Holy shit. What the fuck was that car? Is that just me looking to the side too much and going, oh, I want to go this direction. Oh my god. This track is, I mean, I don't know. I don't know what that fucking was. I don't know if the track was bumpy and then that caused my car to, along with me looking right, I don't know. And trying to be safe, I was in Cletus. God. I belong in the back.
That was a 32.7. Good luck. That's your quickest today. The guy behind has just done a 31.5.
What's going on here with the...
time was at 32.5.
Alright, seems like we're actually gaining on these cars. Oop, a little bit sideways there. The car behind us also is gaining on us, slowly but surely. I have to be aggressive here, I feel. Aggressive but smart.
Go high, stay low. Still there, stay high.
I feel like 5 up above is, or up ahead is, doesn't exactly have a lot of good car control right now. Like, I wonder if his tires are shot. Which, I mean, you can easily do on this track within 15 laps if you overcook them. That was a little bit of a bad corner, but that was only because I had to avoid
behind us now, 0.9.
The car and had to back off and stuff. Whoop. My god. Dude, a slight correction just like fucking kills you. Oh.
That last lap was at 33.6.
I'm kind of surprised there isn't any, there hasn't been a yellow yet, but... I feel like we're saving tires pretty good. Pulling away from the cars behind. I feel like the cars behind
nope. Pace car is out. Line up single file behind car 17. We're under caution. Pits are closed.
I must say that was a little bit unexpected. I'm not quite sure.
It's yellow. It's open.
I'm not quite sure if it's the fuel window yet. So, either way, regardless, I'm still gonna pit.
Watch your speed limit in the pits. Pit lane speed limit is 50 miles per hour. Box in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
To be honest, I'd say that's actually pretty good. All right, that was actually a pretty good pit stop.
Pits are open.
Besides the fact that I was in neutral for a good bit there. It was like, oh yeah, I'm still neutral, doy. So yeah, we're not exactly gonna be good on fuel. But we should be good on tires for most of the race. I'll say, considering how the car felt and how I was feeling and everything. And I mean, 84, 93, 84, 87 for the right sides and whatnot.
Okay, Corey, get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
I mean, it's not exactly that great, I will say, for, you know, for almost 30 laps of running. But I guess it's not that terrible for Atlanta. Old Atlanta. I mean, I'm not really that sure. I'm gonna say that's good. At least that's good for me. Alright, so we're gonna be massively down on pace from a lot of these guys, so at least I feel like, especially now that we're all on new tires, we're all going to be pretty much equalized. And their setups is going to shine more. So. I do believe, yeah, it's going to be 28. Or lap 28, whenever we go green.
Hard inside. Still there.
P15.
Low side's clear. It's car low. Low side's clear.
I saw that coming.
I'm still with you. Clear down low.
I'm kind of glad everyone else behind me saw it and kind of kept clear. I had a little look, but I'm not exactly going to be all that aggressive. Especially since I do believe 8 has a lot more pace than me. I do believe he is a lot quicker. Or not? Oh, holy shit.
Hello, stay high. Keep your line. Clear low.
I'm just gonna hang back for a second. I mean, I'm already in the top 15. I'm good. I'm good.
In front is now 0.9.
Actually happy sitting here in P14, so yeah, we're gonna have to stop for a splash of fuel. I'm gonna actually have to go into the settings and make the crew and game quieter, because I need them active to run off of crew chief,
exactly
the crew chief program.
The head is increasing, it's now 2.4.
Shit. The rear end went a little loose there. Sure that fuel usage is gonna update and we're gonna have to stop for fuel again. With the brake bias a little.
Gap 2, plus gap ahead is now 3.9 seconds.
Whoa.
Time was at 32.6.
Alright, so it looks like we're just running some good consistent lap times.
Okay, Corey, new window open.
Okay, so now up here, pit window's open for fuel. Might have changed a little bit since we got some from the last pit stop.
Time was 33.0.
Okay, so that's actually going to be easy to remember. I pit on lap 25. Kind of expecting a caution at some point, in all honesty.
Corey. We're halfway home. Estimate 34 laps of fuel remaining. That lap time was 33.3. That's good consistency. Keep it up.
I must say, I have been pushing a lot more this time around than I have last time.
You've just done a 33.4.
I haven't actively been doing tire saving like I have last time.
The gap in front is now 5.6.
Keep it in a straight line. Oh, did I really not lose? Did I lose only about a second from that? That's kind of mad. You know what, the rear tires and everything is hot. I need to just take it easy.
The gap in front is now 6.9.
Holy shit, the fucking bumps! To be honest, I mean, we still have about a half a tank. I say we continue on. I mean, don't get me wrong, these tires don't feel great, but they're alright. Although they do that every now and then. Everyone else around me is pitting. The longer I stay out, the more time I lose.
That lap time was 33.8.
But I also risk, you know, the whole cautious shenanigans.
I think I'm in front just now, 7.7.
But holy shit. Did my tires all of a sudden have a runoff? Holy, that bump right there. Like, is it me, or did that become, like, does the car not like it now whenever I ride over it?
You've just done it. It's a 4.1. The car in front of us is Campbell. In front is pitting. Peter, that lap was a 33.8. The leader, Maniac, is pitting. Bookery is now in the lead.
Oh, it's already lap 60. Shit, okay.
Alright, Corey, the next car is Ingall.
Well, okay. So, not this lap, but next lap I'm gonna come into the pits.
The gap to Ingall behind is increasing. It's now.
Okay, yeah,
seconds.
I definitely need to come into the pits next lap.
Car outside. Still there. Outside's clear.
Please, Corey, watch your speed.
Whoops, I accidentally double clicked on my seal, on my pedals.
Box in, 5,
just then.
4, 3, 2, 1. Box now. All clear on pit exit, you can push now. The leader, Vickery, is pitting. Fastest lap for Maniac, 31.2. Ellis is leading the race.
And my gamer ass just thought of Ellis from Left 4 Dead. It would actually be funny as shit if he had the forgetting the fucking race car driver name from the fucking Dead Center campaign. Oh wow, yeah, everything was going dead. That to be fair, I was pushing pretty hard.
That was 32.3.
Alright, let's back it down a little bit because we're using a little bit too much wheel stuff. And we still have about about around 20 to go. So we can lose a little bit of tire if we want to.
The lap time was 32.1. That lap was at 32.4.
Yeah, first place still hasn't pitted since the caution flag. So, still needs to pit. Third place, however, they have pitted. We're looking for a possible top 10. One will more likely catch us up. Holy shit. I wasn't paying exactly attention to the road. Yeah, one is probably gonna catch us up and pass us, but especially if we're gonna take corners like that.
We're in a rookie dog position right now.
Considering how there's the first and second place. Yeah, at least it seems like it. Because whenever they last stopped was lap 25. That was whenever that was whenever the caution waved and everyone came in. So, I mean, they're gonna have to come in here soon. I can't imagine that they're, have that much more gas left.
The gap to Incor behind is now 3.6 seconds.
I mean, they might try to do a master class of fuel saving. Who knows?
Time was 33.3.
I'm guessing there was hoping for a caution or something.
Goal is really new with the gaps now.
I really am hoping that they are gonna pit here soon. Turn on the possible leader. To be honest, Phelps should be the leader.
P12, your last lap time was at 34.4.
Now go. Go cause chaos, my child.
To go. Your lap time.
I want the inside. Inside's clear.
Oh, that made me so nervous. Fuck.
Finish.
Ah. Woo. Top 10. I did not expect that. I guess that was a good strategy, and because I mean, I really did not have all that good of a pace, I think. I don't know. Maybe I was had better some better tires at some parts of the race.
What's your speed limit in the pits?
But
box in five.
From last to top
three,
10.
Two. One.
I'll say that's pretty nice. It only got a 1x for a off-track incident. So actually for once I had a pretty decent race. At my home track. Ooh. Oops. Alright. Laps. Blinker. Bump on the wall. There's gonna be another bump. Yes. Okay, yeah, so all these are pretty much just going to be bumps. I am actually kind of interested in the yellow. I'm guessing it happened somewhere. Actually, hold on. I do believe this is that incident. Did other things happen? That was so weird. What exactly triggered that then? Huh. I honestly don't really know what triggered that caution. I don't really want to investigate all that much. Let's just go on over to the results, or to the results. I just had a brain fart there for a second. All right, let's get this out. Our safety rating has increased ever so more, and then we made it back up to 1500 I rating. Yay! Wow, we were the only B-class car in there. We actually were bottom split. The bottom of the bottom. We were the bottom barrel of the... Yeah, you get the analogy. Anyways, I'm glad that we made it, made it through that race unscathed and with only 1x, actually. So yes, Only one caution. So yeah, actually completed pretty fast, under an hour. So anyways, bit of a unexpected video, especially since it's not the fixed series, but yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. It was some pretty awesome strategy and whatnot. It wasn't really that much action packed, but yeah, I don't know. Sometimes a good race involves good strategy. So, yeah. Anyways, see you next video. Peace.